How is it going, guys? Drew Peacock here, back with another video, and today we have a subscriber rice or nice. This is where you guys submit your cars to me, and I decide based on my own opinion if they are rice or nice. I'm using what I can see in the photos. I'm just forming my opinion based on that. If you don't show underneath your hood and you got something really cool and I don't see it and I call it rice, don't worry, you know what you got. Anyways, I think this episode is probably the best batch of cars I have pulled yet. Honestly, a lot of these are very fucking sick cars. And I hope your guys' cars are in this video. If they're not, send it to my Gmail, drewpeacock.clips@gmail.com, and hopefully you make it in the next one. Anyways, let's go ahead and dive right in. First car is an Alfa Romeo Giulia sedan. And if you guys have not seen Doug DeMiro's video on this car, it is an absolute beast. That is, if it's the quadrifoglio or whatever the hell they call it. If it is, it's an absolute beast. This one is wrapped in a nice matte gold color, and it just pops. It just fits that whole Italian luxury sports car styling, and I think it is absolutely dope. It's a badass wrap. Hopefully, he's got some more shit done to it, but I don't think really wraps in general are just rice. So this one is certified nice. Next car is an Infiniti G37, and this one is a bit of a thick boy. It has to lay off the McDonald's. Look how fat that fucking ass is. Those hips, man. Those hips don't lie, Shakira says. Anyways, this one is absolutely beautiful. The only thing I would really complain about on this is the amount of stickers. I'm not a huge sticker guy. It's all, you know, preference and shit like that. But everything else, the bolted-on body kit and everything, I think it's mint. It is absolutely mint. And he has the performance to back it up. It's one thing to make your car a show car, but to make it a show car and a race car, now that's a whole lot of fun right there. I believe the email said he was pushing like 800 horsepower. I might be wrong, but it was somewhere up there. It was a ridiculous amount, and this thing probably flies. Next car is a Dodge Neon. But based on that intercooler, we all know it is an SRT4 with a drag setup. This is not your mama's Neon. This is a Mexico race car Neon right here. This thing is going to surprise you. It's going to make you regret buying that gas-guzzling V8 because this four-cylinder has come out to play. I don't think a boosted car, well, let me scratch that. Any car could be rice, but this one, a very sleeper look Neon. I mean, I think it's the badge for the most part. No, it's not, but it's very just subtle looking. This car is surely going to surprise a few VA owners out in Mexico. Certified nice. Next car is a Nissan 350Z. We see a lot of ricey 350Zs, but this one, he's got the murdered out look, black wheels. I see that fucking slick in the back, so we know that there's some good underneath the hood. His daily wheels are nice as well, but let's see what's underneath the hood. Oh, well, look who it is, Mr. 2JZ GTE single turbo with the Suprastore intake manifold. That is one certified beast right there. Again, gonna surprise a hell lot of cars out there. I mean, I've seen a lot of slow-ass 350Z slicks. I mean, that's a dead giveaway that you're gonna be pushing some power. But a 2JZ, now that surely would surprise the fuck out of me. For sure, a badass build right there. Next car is a Genesis, and I don't know if it's the 4-banger or the 6-banger. All I know is he's got a lot of aftermarket goodies on the exterior, and hopefully they follow it into the engine bay. Let's take a look. He's got a carbon fiber trunk, nice louvers, nice diffuser, some sexy wheels, Brembo brakes. He's got the full package of exterior mods, even the tow hook to let people know he's serious, but he doesn't show underneath the hood. So based on that, I mean, if he's got nothing underneath the hood, it would be rice at that point. I'm sorry, all this isn't doing much. It's making you look quick, but you got nothing underneath the hood. What's really the point of it? I do see the stupid little heart lanyard or whatever the hell they call these. They're just, I hate those so much. I'm not a fan of those. Yeah, if you got nothing underneath the hood, buddy, I'm sorry, but this is rice. If you do, though, then it's still borderline rice. Anyway, moving on. We have a Toyota Supra. Ooh, we all love Supras, right? Anyways, this one has a really ugly air duct. I don't know why you would do that to your car. The color combo too makes it, I don't know, make me feel like this Supra is a little bit confused. Are you sure you're not thinking you're a Subaru or I don't know. Anyways, this Supra with its blue and gold and its Lambo doors. I mean, the exterior, I'm sorry, this has to be one of the ugliest fucking Supras I've ever seen, but underneath the hood, I'll give you props. It is kind of cool. I mean, it looks like a McDonald's playpen, but at the same time, I mean, that's a big-ass turbo. You know, it's going to be pushing a lot of power. I just wish that your exterior did not look like that. I mean, that's just a little bit depressing. Besides that, though, I mean, I guess it's okay. It is kind of rice. I will say that. But at the same time, he's got the performance to back it up. So let's just call it ugly and call it a day. Let's move on. Next car, Audi R8. That has to be a lot of fucking carbon fiber. That has to be thousands of dollars in carbon fiber. In fact, just the hood alone, I would imagine, is like $2,000 to $3,000. The wing, same thing. I didn't mean for that to rhyme. Drake, sign me, okay? I'm ready to hop on the track. Anyways, this thing looks like it's a track setup. Looks like it's ready to just fucking set record lap times. Probably not because it's an Audi, but at the same time, it looks like it's ready to tear it up. I wanted an Audi R8 for the longest time. I don't think I would want one anymore. I think I'm more of a McLaren guy, but we'll have to see in the future. If my channel keeps growing, we'll have to see what I get. This one is pretty fucking dope, though, I will say. Badass car. Next car is another Nissan 350Z. Let's see if he can keep the same reputation that last 350Z we just saw had. Badass build, by the way. This one has a really ugly rhino style hood. I'm gonna call it the rhino, okay? It's got a rhino. Oh my god, look at that fucking wing. And it's a drop top, man. That has to be the worst Z out there. Not only is it ugly, but it's also a drop top. I mean, and the double decker wing. Yeah, this, I mean, we all have to agree on this one. This one right here is rice. Next car, Shelby GT 350R in a battleship gray or Nardo gray, whatever you want to call it. It is a nice aggressive color for these modern muscle cars. I feel like all these car manufacturers are coming up with the same colors, but they all look so good on each car, so I don't really blame them. This one is indeed Whipple supercharged too, man. 750 horsepower minimum. This one, that is one badass build. We all know that ain't rice. That is nice. Ooh, a Nissan 300ZX. I swear, if I had a 300ZX instead of the 200SX that I used to have, I don't think I would have sold it. I think these cars are beautiful as is. You don't got to do much to them. And this one's really nice, man. I like it. Even though it's stock, I just wanted to show you guys how clean these things. For a 40-year-old car, I mean, that is a fucking mint 300ZX. Speaking of Zs, here's a 350Z. We had one good one already and one bad one. Let's see which one this one falls under. We got what looks like a Nismo with a carbon fiber hood. I'm not a fan of those wheels. I just got to say it. Those wheels, I mean, even though they're factory, it looks like they're fucking ugly. They look like flower petals. Not a fan of them. Nismo, 350Z. I mean, it's hard to call it rice. Not the biggest fan of the rear bumper. I like the front bumper, but the boxy rear bumper, it's kind of grown on me. It kind of looks cool, but at the same time, it's like, does not match the rest of the car. Does not match it at all. The wheels, though, the wheels are the worst thing in my opinion. Those are fucking hideous. Anyways, I think it's okay. It's okay, I guess. Ooh, this on the other hand, I think this is a little bit more than just okay. I mean, the drag setup lets you know it's pretty quick already, but when you got a front bumper dump exhaust, how big is a spoolie snail? Let's take some guesses down in the comments. Carbon fiber hood, nice, aggressive, sleek styling, black and gray. Those two go together like Subarus and Cobb stickers. I think the email said like 800 horsepower, again, something like that, somewhere around there. A lot of horsepower, big turbo. I think I accidentally didn't download the engine shot, so we're gonna have to move on to this boosted Scion FRS wide body, hopefully on bags, because that fitment is a little bit too high for my own taste. This car looks like a race car. I think it is a race car. It makes me want to believe it's a race car. I'm hoping it's a race car because it's got a lot of aggressive styling and a lot of aggressive stickers on it to make it look like a race car. But again, if it's not, then I don't know. It's boosted, but do you really need two wings if it's not a track car? I don't even think track cars need two wings, not with something like that. Even though it's boosted, just based on what I can see here, I'm gonna have to say it's somewhat rice. I feel like if he took off most of these stickers, maybe left on the number if it was an actual track car, I feel like it would be a lot better. But I mean, the two wings, I don't know. Let's move on though to this Challenger Hellcat. Psych. We got hood pins on a factory hood. We have a fake hood scoop on a factory hood. We have Wolverine scratch marks. Hemi Sport. Didn't know that they made that model. We have, what is that, two front lips? One, two? With the most random support rods ever. Oh my god, man. This thing is a certified piece of shit. Not even certified rice. It's just certified junk. Obviously not one of your guys' cars. I thought it was fucking ugly enough to include it anyways. Wow. I mean, yeah, that's what happens when you don't know what the fuck you're doing and modding a car. Moving on to probably the best sleeper of this episode. If you saw this pull up on you, what would you think is about to happen? You'd probably think nothing. You probably wouldn't even, you know, bat an eye at it. You'd be like, oh, that's an old person's car. But when it's got a fucking 2J underneath the hood, now we're talking. Looks like the factory twin turbo setup, though, so it's still pushing that factory 1,000 horsepower. I mean, you can't go wrong with that, right? But besides that, just a very badass sleeper car. Mazda Miata NB, the second least wanted Miata, next to the NC, that is. Anyways, this one's got some fender flares, some pretty wide wheels, stock motor, it looks like, underneath the hood, nice roll cage to protect you if you're gonna fucking send it, a little itty bitty wing, and it looks like it's ready to hit the track. These cars, you don't need to do a lot to them to have fun. Like, you don't really want to push, like, 700 horsepower through your Miata. I think that's a death wish at that point. Like, you don't need to have a lot of horsepower to have fun. And the Miata is proof of that. But when you take your Honda Civic and you make it look like a Type R when it's not a Type R, I think you have just cooked up the perfect recipe for a ricer. Yeah, I mean, it looks like it's the sport model, maybe, maybe not, but to me, it's a wannabe Type R. Like, if you put on the Type R wing and you don't have the Type R, it's a wannabe Type R at that point. You even have, like, a crazy wrap and a crazy front lip and a crazy diffuser. So, I mean, I'm sorry, Honda Civic. This is rice. Moving on, though, to the classic era, looking at one hell of a restoration. This thing is in mint condition. That steering wheel has to be thinner than my poop when I eat Taco Bell. That came out of nowhere. But anyways, interior, mint condition. Underneath the hood, mint condition. Exterior, mint condition. This is how you do a restoration. I would do a resto mod, make it a little bit more modern, but this is one good example of a classic Mustang. Obviously not rice, because there ain't shit really done to it. Actually, it looks like maybe a big motor underneath the hood. My bad, I'm a little bit blind. But besides that, sick-ass Mustang. On those tires, though, probably does not hook. Anyway, guys, that was the last car. A lot of good-ass cars. I'm telling you, man, each email I clicked on was just another winner, another winner, another winner. We had a few ricers, but the majority of you guys this episode were winners. It doesn't matter, though, what I say. It's all just opinionated. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to submit your car, send it to my Gmail, drewpeacock.clips@gmail.com. Subscribe to see more videos like this one, and until next video, peace.